9 a.m. Eastern right here on NHL Network. Time for some 5-Minute Major with some topics that we haven't got a chance to get to yet in the show. So let's throw 5 minutes on the clock.
There should be a bing when it comes up.
Yeah. All right, we will start with Niklas Hjalmarsson getting the standing ovation in his return. An emotional moment. Is players returning to their former team's barn one of the most emotional moments we see in sports sometimes when they've spent a long time there?
No.
What? Why not? They always cry.
So harsh.
I know. I don't get why they're crying. I mean, everyone's situation is different. Maybe there's something personal
not
there.
Not everyone but moved around as much as you.
Oh, easy.
I'm sorry. Kind of.
Sorry.
You've been working with me too long now.
Yeah,
that's when it comes to that.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, it was emotional. It was emotional, and he has won some Stanley Cups there. He had a lot of history there.
Yes.
Most of those guys that he knew there. Who knows what else was what other experience he's had in Chicago.
Yeah. But generally speaking,
going back there,
it's a year and a half ago. Without any personal information, what may be going on in his life? It's a year and a half ago. Like,
yeah.
I get you're excited. You're in the middle of the game too. You've been playing. You've been jabbing. You've been sticking.
I like to see him.
I don't dislike him for it. I just think it's unusual.
Not everybody's this
PK
cold.
PK Subban balling his eyes at the blue line. I know.
No, come
on. Maybe says something more about me than them.
Yeah,
probably.
Perhaps.
Everybody's different.
I cry at movies.
Shed a little love. Yeah. You know. Come on.
Moving right along.
Love.
Tampa.
There we go.
Perfect. On the penalty kill to start the season through 5 games. It's the longest streak to start.
Let's ask our penalty killing guru, Mike Johnson, who informed us in the break. He was always on the penalty kill, and I could see why, because Johnny's a smart guy. He's kind of lanky. He's got the long stick probably going. Give us your thought on this.
Well, they changed the coaching staff. That's part of the reason why, was to get this power play better. They were not very good last
year.
Or the penalty kill better. They were not very good last year. Jeff Halpern brought in, who was a really good penalty killer during his NHL career. Now, this is probably a little bit of luck involved as well, but they added Joseph, who's very fast and speedy. Brayden Point's really good. They have the personnel to be good in the penalty kill, which is surprising why they weren't last year. It's going to be a big part why they win games.
And they have a good goalie, too, which helps.
Yeah, not only killing penalties, scoring on the penalty kill, too.
Was it easy to kill penalties when you had a better goalie?
Very much so. Everything's easier when you got a better goalie.
That's right.
All right, well, how about the Carolina Hurricanes? Off to a very surprising start, although their special teams might be cause for concern.
Yeah.
Worst PK in the league, power plays bottom five.
Yeah, and, that is a little bit of – because you look at the Hurricanes, you were wondering, are they for real? Can they really make a push this year? But when I see those numbers, I worry particularly about the penalty killing. We get back to the goalies, right? It helps when you have a good goalie in there. They've kind of had a couple different guys in goal so far. But they've got to be better on the penalty kill for sure. And then the power play isn't getting much done for them. And that's another area where they have the personnel to be better than 28.
Sebastian Aho alone should be get it to double digits. But you will not make the playoffs for the penalty kill killing in the 60s.
No, you
just won't.
No,
games are too close.
No.
They're not that good to withstand that kind of poor performance. They have to figure that out. But Rod Brindamore was a great penalty killer. He should be able to figure it out.
Yeah.
All right, we got two teams left in the NHL that have yet to win a hockey game. The Panthers taking on the Caps tonight, and the Red Wings. Who will win first?
Well, they play each other, don't they?
On Friday or Saturday.
But first the Panthers play the Capitals tonight.
Tonight, yeah.
So who wins first?
They play each other tomorrow, so someone's going to win tomorrow.
We both are kind of the mind that maybe the Caps at home tonight will get it done, which will set the table for a battle of the winless between these two teams. I will say this for the Red Wings. They look better in their game against Tampa last night, and they're getting some guys healthy on defense. Trevor Daley played last night, so that's a big plus for them. Who will win first? I mean, I would favor Florida because I think they're the better team, but...
I'm saying Florida.
Yeah.
They're at home tomorrow. They get a couple cracks
at it.
Second
back-to-back.
But they get two chances at it.
Yeah.
Right? They get the
probability.
As well.
Probability, man.
And here's the other thing for the Red Wings. I know they haven't been winning, but that day off in Florida on a Friday night.
Ooh. Golf action.
All right. We'll see.
Check their necks to see if they look a little red.
Red.
Ooh,
sun
good call.
Necks.
I like that.
Golfing.
All right. Last but certainly not least, the Ducks set to retire Paul Kariya's number on Sunday. This is going to be big.
What do you think? What did you remember about playing against? You must have crossed paths with him somewhere along
even
the line.
Even in college. My first year in college was his last year at Maine.
He only played one, right?
The one and a half.
And he was so good.
Yeah, 100 points his freshman year. He played at a speed that Connor McDavid plays at now, but back then when not everyone could skate. He was so fast, and the wrist shot and the skills and the uniqueness of his edge work. He was awesome to watch, one of my favorite players and a teammate of mine in St. Louis at the end of my career, and his as well. A quality guy and certainly deserves to have up there.
And if he did not get injured, he was very seriously injured when I think it was Gary Suter cross-checked him right in the head. I mean, it would have been a bigger suspension now than it was then. And that really set him back, concussion issues. He was a wonderful player to watch.
And him and Timu were like, they were the perfect pair because of the odd couple personality-wise, but they complemented each other perfectly on the ice.